In the aftermath of the Soviet Union, the newly formed Russian Federation had a problem. Since the late 1940s, the North Atlantic Treaty Organization stood as a military alliance among the most powerful countries on Earth to oppose the USSR's enormous reach. But in the early 1990s, without control over its former Soviet empire, Russia seemed relatively defenseless, and so did its Eurasian neighbors. This predicament sparked a NATO-like association of post-Soviet states called the Collective Security Treaty Organization. So, just how powerful is Russia's largest military alliance, and how does it fare against NATO? Well, the CSTO was formed in May of 1992, barely 6 months after the collapse of the Soviet Union. This Russia-led organization included Armenia, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, and Uzbekistan, all formerly Soviet entities. Within a few years, three more states joined: Azerbaijan, Belarus, and Georgia. Collectively, these nine countries agreed to work together militarily, and most importantly, provide support and security. The CSTO charter clearly states that their goals include strengthening of peace, international and regional security and stability, protection of independence on a collective basis, territorial integrity and sovereignty of the member states. So, a formalized mutual defense treaty. But while the CSTO was intended to serve as a counterpoint to NATO, it has ultimately fallen very short of its goal. First of all, since its creation, the CSTO has lost three member states, Azerbaijan, Georgia, and Uzbekistan, all of whom have distanced themselves from an increasingly territorial Russia. The remaining states, when pitted against NATO, seem mostly ineffective. NATO accounts for more than half of the world's military spending and contains many of the most powerful militaries. And while NATO has spent much of the 20th century actually working together to aid member states, the CSTO has failed in its comparatively short lifetime. In 2010, Kyrgyzstan saw ethnic violence rock its borders and called on the CSTO for help. The organization had refused, saying that was a domestic matter and not covered by their joint agreement. Then 2 years later, Tajikistan asked for help in resolving an autonomous dispute, which involved rebel and military forces attacking each other. Again, the CSTO refused. Perhaps most damningly, while a major function of the CSTO is ostensibly to support Russian influence in the region, the country's most controversial military incursion has been soundly rejected by most member states. Following the invasion of Crimea, all members except Armenia criticized the violation of Ukraine's territorial integrity. Most of the Union also refused to vote in favor of Russian policy regarding Syria at the United Nations. In short, while the CSTO may be a mutual defense collective on paper, in practice, not only is the group devoid of power, but it also works against advancing Russian policy in multiple areas. So the CSTO isn't quite the NATO alternative it was meant to be. But how powerful and effective is NATO anyway? You can find out by watching this video to the right. Thanks for tuning in to Now This World, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more episodes every week.